Dear students, today let us derive the expression for magnetic dipole moment of the electron due to its orbital motion, due to its spinning motion, and hence the total magnetic dipole moment. Now, let us consider the revolving electron. The electron is revolving in the elliptical path, in the elliptical orbit. Let A be the area of this loop or this elliptical orbit. And let T the period of revolution of the electron in this elliptical orbit. A is the area of the loop, T is the period of revolution. The electron, in its motion, it crosses any point in this elliptical path. It crosses any point of the elliptical path in unit time by 1 by T times. In every second, the electron crosses any point 1 by T times. And this motion of the electron in this orbit, it is equivalent to the current I. And current I is rate of change of charge. So that here I is E by T. E charge of the electron, T time taken by the electron to revolve in this loop of area A. This current I, due to the motion of the electron, that gives rise to magnetic moment. And you have studied in your second BSc class, a current carrying loop behaves like a magnetic dipole. A current carrying loop behaves like a magnetic dipole and it possesses dipole moment. This is Ampere, according to Ampere's theorem, the dipole moment, it is a magnetic dipole moment. Dipole moment, it is due to, see here, the electron is revolving, orbital motion of the electron, and here we consider the magnetic moment as orbital magnetic moment. Orbital dipole moment, mu L, it is given by I into A, product of the current and area of the loop. This is Ampere's theorem. So we apply that one here. So the orbital magnetic moment, orbital magnetic dipole moment of the electron is given by I into A. So that mu L is, what is I? E by T. We get mu L as E A by T. Now, let us see. The area of the loop, it is A. The electron is moving. So that aerial velocity of this, in this central orbit, aerial velocity of the electron in this orbit, it is given by half R square d phi by dt. This one also you have studied in your first BSc. The aerial velocity is given by this formula. Half r square d phi by dt. D phi by dt is orbital angular momentum. Orbital angular velocity. D phi by dt is orbital angular velocity or angular velocity. So, and aerial velocity. How do you define aerial velocity? Rate of change of area. That is dA by dt. So that dA by dt is half r square d phi by dt. What is r? The radius vector. Distance between the nucleus and the electron when the electron orbits in the path. So that from this, you can write dA as half r square d phi by dt into dt. Then, total area of the loop. We get it by integrating this expression between the limit 0 and t. Now, the angular momentum of the electron. The electron is orbiting in the elliptical orbit. Its angular momentum. Angular momentum is either mvr or mr square omega. What is omega? Angular velocity, nothing but d phi by dt. And we denote angular momentum as pl. Orbital angular momentum denoted as pl. So pl is given by mr square d phi by dt. Now, in this expression for area, the total area, say we multiply this one by m and divide by m. Multiplying and dividing by m, we change the form of this expression as this. And here, this mr square d phi by dt, mr square d phi by dt is taken as pl. So that this expression, this one reduces to this form. Mr square d phi by dt is taken as pl divided by 2m into dt. Integrate between the limit 0 and t. So that we get area as PL by 2m into t. Now, substitute this area A in the expression for mu L. Mu L is E by T into A, so that we get mu L as E by T into PL by 2M into T. T gets cancelled, E by 2M into PL. What is PL? Orbital angular momentum. And it is quantized, so that PL is equal to PL is either LH bar or as per the wave mechanics, it is root of L into L plus 1 H bar. PL is either LH bar or this. If you consider this one, PL is substituted as square root of L into L plus 1 H bar. H bar is H by 2 pi. So that mu L is EH by 4 pi m into root this. And this EH by 4 pi m, a constant taken as mu b and known as or called as Bohr electron magneton or Bohr magneton. And Bohr magneton, it is the smallest unit of magnetic dipole moment. Bohr magneton, the smallest unit of magnetic dipole moment, and its value is by substituting EH 4 pi m E 1.6 10 power minus 19, H value 6.625 10 power minus 34, 4 pi and m, mass of the electron, we get mu b as 9.274 into 10 power minus 4 joule per Tesla. This is the value of Bohr magneton, which is the smallest unit of magnetic dipole moment. Hence, the expression for orbital magnetic moment is mu b root L into L plus 1. And the electron also possesses spinning motion. In the orbit, electrons, they spin about their own axis. So they possess spin magnetic moment also, denoted as mu s. The spin magnetic moment, it is given dipole moment. Spin magnetic dipole moment, it's given by mu s. It is 2 EH by 4 pi m root s into s plus 1. Or it is 2 mu b s into s plus 1. This is the magnetic dipole moment due to spin. Now, what is the total magnetic moment? Total magnetic dipole moment, mu j, nothing but resultant of mu l and mu s. Resultant of mu l and mu s is total magnetic dipole moment. This is dipole moment. Now, we have mu l and we have mu s. Using these two, let us find out the expression for mu j. See here, when we plot the dipole moment vectors mu L and mu S as also L and S, the resultant of orbital angular momentum, spin angular momentum, the resultant is total angular momentum J. Similarly, the resultant of mu S and mu L, it is total magnetic dipole moment mu J. And it is observed that actually the total magnetic moment mu J, it should be along the direction of J. And here the resultant of mu L and mu S is found to be along this direction. It is mu. And this mu is not exactly along the direction of J. So that to get the total magnetic dipole moment mu J should be along the direction of J. But the resultant of mu L and mu S, it is obtained along this direction. This is the resultant mu. So mu resultant of mu S and mu L. But we have to get the resultant along the direction J. It is mu J. So to get mu j, the effective value of this magnetic moment, that is mu j, we consider the components of mu l and mu s. The components of mu l and mu s along mu j, that is along the direction of j. Find the components of mu l and mu s along the direction of j. Then by adding them, we get the resultant or the total magnetic moment mu j. That's the resultant magnetic moment along the direction of j. Now the components of mu l and mu s along j are nothing but the components are, we have mu l is mu b root l into l plus 1, or also it can also be taken as mu b l. This can be taken as 2 mu b s also. Now the component of mu l along mu j is mu BL cos LJ, cosine of angle between L and J. See this angle, cosine of this angle. This is the component of mu L along J. Similarly, component of mu S along J, nothing but 2 mu B into cosine of the angle between mu s and mu j, this angle. Then we add these two components. So this is nothing but mu b l, this is nothing but 2 mu b s, then the cosine angles. Now apply cosine rule. As per cosine rule, cos lj is l square plus j square minus s square by 2lj. Cos sj is s square plus j square minus l square by 2sj. Then we get mu j as, see, eh by 4 pi m is constant, keep it outside. Then inside the bracket you get l square plus j square minus s square by 2j, because here one, this l gets cancelled with this. This l cancels with this. This s cancels with this, so that inside we get this. Now common denominator is 2j and the numerator. Simplify, you get the numerator as 3j square plus s square minus l square by 2j into eh by 4 pi m. Now one more rearrangement in the next step here. It is into j by j. Multiply and divide by j. Multiply the numerator and denominator by j. So that you get, see, a j. This j is kept outside, and 1j along with this, clubbed with this, 2j square. So the term becomes EHJ by 4 pi m. And numerator, this 3j square, we write it as 2j square plus j square. Plus s square minus l square by 2j square. That is EHJ by 4 pi m. And into, inside the bracket, 2j square by 2j square. That is 1 plus this term by 2j square. That is kept as it is. Or mu j is EH by 4 pi m j into 1 plus j square. It's nothing but, see, we have quantum mechanically the condition for j. It can also be taken as root of j into j plus 1. Square means it is j into j plus 1. Similarly, root s into s plus 1. Or it is s square means it is s into s plus 1. L square is replaced by l into l plus 1. So we get mu j as this. Or mu j is also given by EH by 4 pi m j into g. This full term is taken as g, a constant known as Landé's splitting factor, or Landé's g factor, also called as gyroscopic splitting factor. And this is the expression for total magnetic dipole moment of the electron. EH by 4 pi m. What is EH by 4 pi m? Mu b, Bohr magneton, j into g. J is the total quantum number, total orbital quantum number is j. J is total orbital quantum number. This is about total magnetic dipole moment. Now the electron, when it is placed in the magnetic field, that electron gains additional energy. The additional energy gained by the electron or the atom, when the atom is placed in the external magnetic field, it gains energy. The electron gains energy. The additional energy, extra energy gained by that atom, denoted as delta E, along with its actual energy E, an extra energy is gained. Delta E, it's given by the dot product of mu j and b. Energy, dot product of energy, nothing but the work done, dot product of these two vectors. When an electron placed in a magnetic field, the work done, nothing but energy, is mu j dot b vector. It is mu j b cos theta. Expand this, mu j b cos theta. What is mu j? Mu b g j into b cos theta. Or it is mu b g b into j cos theta. And this j cos theta is nothing but m j, the magnetic total quantum number. Total magnetic quantum number m j. In the presence of the external field, the total quantum number, magnetic quantum number, denoted as mj. So that the extra energy gained by the electron is EH by 4 pi m g b into mj. The value of delta E changes with mj. It depends on mj. And this is about the additional energy gained by the atom in an external magnetic field. Next is Larmor's theorem, or Larmor's precision. Larmor's precision here. When the electron or the atom is placed in an external magnetic field, when an atom is placed in an external magnetic field, then the electrons moving in their orbit, their orbital motion is the motion of the electrons in a definite orbit that is superimposed with the motion of the orbit itself. The entire orbit starts moving or starts rotating about the direction of the applied magnetic field. This rotation or this precession is called Larmor precession. In the Larmor theorem, what it says is the effect of the magnetic field on an electron moving in an orbit. See, electron is moving in its own orbit. When the external field is applied, the effect of the external magnetic field is to superimpose on the orbital motion of the electron, see, another motion, that is the motion of the entire orbit about the direction of the magnetic field. And the angular velocity with which this orbit rotates about the direction of the field is Larmor's velocity, angular Larmor velocity or precession velocity, denoted as omega p, denoted as omega p. Now, to find the expression for this omega p, it is Be by 2m. Let us derive the expression for this omega p, Larmor, the velocity of Larmor precession, angular velocity. Now, consider an atom placed in a very strong magnetic field B. An atom placed in a very strong magnetic field B. Now, the atom which behaves like a tiny magnet, when this magnet is placed in the magnetic field, it experiences a torque. The torque experienced by this atom, nothing but the electron there, with orbital magnetic moment mu L. The electron has got the magnetic moment due to its orbital motion, it is mu L. So now this electron experiences a torque in the field B. That torque is given by cross product of mu L and B. Mu L vector cross B vector is the torque experienced by that electron, that atom in that magnetic field B. And mu L is mu B L. So this one becomes mu B L cross B vector. What is mu B? EH by 4 pi m, that of the electron. So we consider the negative sign, minus EH by 4 pi m, Bohr magneton, into L cross B. Or this is nothing but, if you rearrange this, this can also be written as minus E by 2m into LH by 2 pi. We write this one as minus E by 2m LH by 2 pi into B vector. What is LH by 2 pi? LH by 2 pi, the quantum condition for orbital angular momentum. Orbital angular momentum is quantized, that is L vector is LH by 2 pi. So LH by 2 pi is L vector. So that the torque experienced by the atom or the electron is minus E by 2m L vector cross B vector. This is the torque. What is torque? By definition, rate of change of angular momentum. Therefore, dl vector by dt, rate of change of angular momentum, dl vector by dt is minus E by 2m L vector cross B vector. And here it says this dl vector is perpendicular to both L vector and B vector. Dl vector by dt is the cross product of this. So dl vector is perpendicular to both L vector and B vector. Now, from this expression 1, the magnitude of dl vector by dt, it is dl by dt, nothing but E by 2m, L cross B is LB sin theta. This is the magnitude, dl by dt, the rate of magnitude of the torque. Magnitude of torque is E by 2m LB sin theta. If theta is the angle between the direction of L vector and the vector B, theta is angle between the direction of this L vector. See, this is L vector and this is B vector. So this is angle theta. Now, the component of L vector, this is the plane of precession. This is the plane of precession. Now, the component of L in the plane of precision, in this plane, the component of L, this L makes an angle theta with the direction of B. L makes angle theta with the direction of B, and this L vector itself is rotating about B so that the orbit of the electron that itself is rotating about the direction of B. So this is the plane of rotation of the orbit, and this is the plane of rotation of L, so that the component of L in the plane of precession in this plane, it's given by L sine theta. This is theta, this is L, so this is the plane where the component of this L is L sine theta, this is the component. So from this triangle we get this as L sine theta. Now this orbiting vector, let d phi, the angle subtended, this d phi angle subtended by this dl vector at the point where B passes through the plane of precession. D phi angle subtended by dl vector in this plane at the point where this B passes through. In this plane, dl vector, this arc subtends an angle d phi at this point where this field passes through. So that from this, you can write the relation between dl, d phi and l sine theta. Apply S equal to r theta. So dl equal to l sine theta d phi. You can write dl, magnitude of dl vector, mod is it, dl as d phi l sine theta, or d phi is mod dl by l sine theta. See here, S equal to r theta. That rule we apply. Dl is equal to l sine theta d phi. So dl is l sine theta d phi, or d phi is this. Now, define angular velocity of precession. Angular velocity, rate of d phi by dt. Angular velocity is d phi by dt. Therefore, d phi by, from this, d phi by dt is nothing but d by dt of this. That is, d by dt of dl by l sine theta. Here, 1 by, the variation is, the variable is dl. So, this is 1 by l sine theta into dl by dt. What is dl by dt? We have here, dl by dt is e by 2m lb sine theta. Substitute dl by dt as el b sine theta. So that from this we get, say l sine theta gets cancelled. What's remaining? Eb by 2m. Thus, the angular velocity of precession or Larmor velocity, it is given by Eb by 2m. This expression. From this, Larmor frequency, what is it? It is, we have nu. Nu is omega p by, omega is 2 pi nu. We use that. Omega is equal to 2 pi into nu. So nu is omega by 2 pi. This is Larmor frequency. Frequency of Larmor precession. This is about the Larmor precession or rotation of the angular orbital angular momentum vector about the field direction. With this, I stop here. Let us consider this Stern-Gerlach experiment in the next class.